gosh, I see all my little zebras are already crisscrossed applesauce. You guys are doing awesome, and eyes are up here. I so much appreciate that. Just a few reminders, we thank you very much, those of you up in the stands, for being here today, and appreciate your help in working with us with the new process of getting your kids picked up. You know, of course, our number one goal at Columbia is just always keeping the kids safe, and so we really appreciate your support. I know sometimes it's not the easiest system to do that, but we know that you would want us to keep your kiddos safe. So we appreciate your support in that. Also, just a couple reminders, we have really tried to mix restroom breaks during Zebra Zone because, of course, you know, anybody who knows kids knows that if one person goes to the restroom, then 15 other people need to go to the restroom. So we just try to keep that to only for an emergency. Those of you in the stands are old and they're creaky, so if you move around very much, they get very loud, and then that's a big distraction for our kids. And also talking is a big distraction for the kids and also for the people up here who've worked really hard to put on the show. So we just appreciate you staying very quiet and showing the kids how to be a great audience and setting a good example for them, okay? And little zebras, you guys are awesome. You're all over it. We're gonna talk about peace today, okay? And you guys have done a great job this month of showing peace at Columbia, and we are gonna learn some more, okay? Are you ready? Okay, let's get going.
Everybody, welcome to Zebra Zone. My name's Jenny, and I'm so excited to see you all here today. If this is your first time with us, this is where kids bring their parents to learn, and each month we have a character trait that we work on all month long. Kids have been doing a great job, I hear, with the character trait this month. I'm excited about it. It's a really powerful one, and we'll learn more.
Excusez-moi.
Hello?
Pardon me, but I believe I am here to help you with your character trait.
Who is that?
It is I, the Barber of Columbia.
What are you doing?
I am here to demonstrate the power of today's character trait. Have you revealed the definition yet?
I haven't. I was just getting ready to.
Well, please continue as I set up for today's demonstration.
Okay, well, Becky sets up for her demonstration. Let's go ahead and reveal our character trait. Everybody on the count of three, ready? One, two, three. It is peace. Peace is proving you care more about each other than winning an argument. So let's read that together. Peace, proving you care more about each other than winning an argument.
Awesome.
Okay, looks like Becky's working on a demonstration, so let's find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, today we will learn a very valuable lesson. A lesson that each and every one of us can take part in. Another way to say it is this. Peace is proving that you care by letting go of one's hair.
Yes! I mean, what?
I mean, okay, well, another way you can look at it is this. In order for you to make peace with anybody, you must absolutely, without a doubt, cut your hair off.
No,
so,
okay.
Let's see. Do I have a willing participant? Does anybody need a little snippity snip off the scalpity scalp? Don't be nervous. Any adults out there? No. But all these kids are way braver than you guys. You shouldn't be nervous because I've watched TV. I've seen Edward Scissorhands. You, sir, you look perfect for this. Would you be willing to join me up on stage? Awesome. Okay, what's your name? This is Justin. Everybody say, hey, Justin. Silence, silence in your mouth. I am getting ready to bring this man closer to peace by cutting his hair off. Isn't that really fun? I get it. It's all about the peace. Maestro, if you would, please.
Thank you.
way. Oh, wrong. Peace is showing you care about others by letting go of what's fair, not hair.
Well, then, this is totally awkward.
Yes! A man has an ice cream sundae on his head.
Okay, well, you know, I think, I don't know about you guys, but sir, I think this would be a great time to let go of any anger you may have towards me, or resentment, or bitterness, by you know, which would be a really super fair reaction, and make peace with me by forgiving me. Do you forgive me?
No.
He forgives me. See, I told you this would be a great example.
Well, it's an example. Please take this gentleman backstage and get him a towel.
Okay. Why don't you follow me? Would you mind helping me carry this stuff? I mean, I did do this. I think you look great, though. All right.
Come on, guys!
I think we
Valentine's Day and prove to you that it is the best, awesomest, coolest holiday out there, and I'm going to have the most support for it. So, there.
Not a holiday. No day off. Well, I'll show her. I will make this the President's Day to remember forever. I will not be distraught. I am focused. Nothing is going to keep me from my quest. Ice cream man! Ice cream!
I know that I said some things I shouldn't have. I know that I left you down and feeling sad. And all the things I did, I cannot take them back. Cause I know that this is not the answer. The same mind is not the way.
Peace. teachers had a little argument over who got to go first and second, but while they were deciding, I got a piece, and I said, how about we just stop this argument, because it's not fun having an argument, it's fun to play a game.
So we've had kiddos who have been able to kind of break up a little argument between friends. We've had kids who have given up their seat or given up their place in line. We've had kids who have done all kinds of cool stuff. You guys have really understood what that means to show peace. Sometimes it's better to just agree to disagree, right? Just say, you know what, we're not going to agree on this, so let's not fight. Let's just, you know, say, hey, we just have different opinions, right? So you guys have done an awesome job of that this month, and I'm very proud of you. And now it is time to find that one person who is going to be the winner of a new bicycle. Zebby, will you please help me out and hold this bucket? We had probably, I don't know what, 25 in there this month. So we have lots of kids showing peace. I'm very proud of you. This month's bicycle winner is a second grade girl in Mrs. Musselman's class, and she showed peace by giving up her seat for someone who wanted it without even arguing. That is Savannah Eccles. Come on, come see it. Woo! Look at you! Good job, Savannah! You just told me in the hallway! You said, I showed peace, Mrs. Gar, didn't you? I am so proud of you. So can you tell us what happened? Do you remember? You gave up your seat, it says. So if somebody else kind of wanted your seat. And some kids might be like, no, this is my seat. But not you, right? You just said, all right, nothing to fight about. You can have it. Do you have a bicycle? Ooh, guess what? Next week, you and me going to Walmart, we're going to find you one, okay? I'm very proud of you, Savannah. Keep up the good work. Let's give her another big round of applause. For the rest of this month, I want you guys to continue showing peace, okay? Because even if there's not a bicycle to be won, do you think that we get further with our friends and in life when we choose peace? Don't you think that's the way to go? Yeah, I think so too. I think people are really going to appreciate that. I'm very proud of all of you, okay? Enjoy the rest of the show.
getting along and play and be kind to others. I show peace by not arguing.
I want the race. I want the race.
I want the race.
I want the race. Guys, it doesn't matter who won or lost. We have a special thing to eat off. Oh, what you want, okay guys?
If you are in an argument and if you don't know how to get out, just walk away.
I show peace of this way when others are coming.
Not a holiday, no day off.
Wow. I was really dumb. Before that weird interruption, I was saying that Valentine's Day is the awesomest holiday out there because it's all about love and caring about one another. Plus, there's the chocolate and candy.
Candy? Where's the candy at? I love candy.
You can have just a little bit. They're over there. Don't overdo it.
What did they say, bro?
Your feet smell? That's not very Valentine-y.
What? You smell like trash? Kick me? Seriously, is this your handiwork?
I cannot tell a lie. Maybe it was, maybe it wasn't. Would this be a good time for me to take the floor? Thanks. I have in my hand a signed, notarized decree from Mrs. F. that I get to decorate the clubhouse for President's Day. I call it the Declaration of Decoration.
Seriously?
Oh, yeah. We, the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect holiday, establish a decorating theme, ensure decoration tranquility, provide for the common people, promote the general decorating, and secure the day as the best February holiday to ourselves and our posterior, do ordain and establish this Declaration of Decoration. See it right there, signed, Mrs. F.
I don't even know what to do with it. How am I supposed to deal with this?
If you would control your outbush, I think I have the floor. And especially after what I have to say, I just don't want to hear anymore. You ready?
Here it comes.
I can see.
What?
I can see. You can decorate for Valentine's Day.
Marshall, what happened to this Declaration of Decorations? President's Day is the best. What happened to all that?
Well, I've decided to be an example of Of rather walking away from the arguments, keeping a friend. I do it in the name of our best, most noble presence.
I don't know what to say, Marshall.
How about Happy Valentine's Day?
It is the best holiday.
No day off, not a real holiday.
Hey, what happened to all this peace stuff? Well, I have to say, guys, I was pretty thrown off and taken aback when Marshall conceded to me and Valentine's Day. It just goes to show you that it's worth it to prove you care more about one another than you do just winning an argument. Peace.
Oh.
I have to admit that the day ended a whole lot different than it started out this morning. But that's a good thing, because I truly believe in peace. More important to keep that friend and not worry about the argument. Peace out.
So, let's talk about peace, boys and girls. How can you be an example for peace when you're in your classroom? Can anyone give me an example? I don't have a mic. I'll just repeat what you said. Yeah. Oh, she said that peace is showing that when you don't want to clean up, you can help someone else clean up, and that's showing peace between people. How can you show peace at home? Because we don't just show our character traits here at school, we also do it at home. Where else can we do that?
Clean up their toys.
Oh, you could help maybe your brother and sister clean up the toys instead of fighting over who has to do it and who doesn't. Let's get one more example, maybe from second grade.
Yeah.
How can you show peace?
By helping your mom.
Helping your mom.
Cook.
Okay. Maybe you are just arguing you don't want to do your chores tonight. You just had a long day at school and you could just help your mom instead. That's showing peace. So it sounds like you guys have a good grip on how we can show peace here at school and at home. So let's go over our character trait one more time. Peace. Proving you care more about each other than winning an argument. All right, everybody, thank you so much for coming. Parents, want to thank you so much for coming. We're going to ask that you stay seated, and as we get ready to wrap up, the students are going to exit out these doors, and we'd like for parents to head back toward the office. So thank you so much. Let's stand up on our feet.